Hello and welcome to BlackCooMinistries.com. We are on lesson number 21 and we are talking about what time is it? And today, Sandy, tell everyone, what time are we going to be talking about today?
It's a time to be appointed.
A time to be appointed. That's right. Gina, share with us, explain or define, what does that word appointed mean to you? Share that with the audience.
To me, that means that you're being designated. You're being placed. Equipped, arranged. There's an appointment. Like, for example, you go to the class and you're appointed to be the leader of a group. Something along that lines. That's what I think of as when I think of appointed.
All right, but you got a great definition, and that is exactly what my line of thought is too. When we think of that word appointed, another word, let me add to that, chosen. I like what you use, designated. You know, you use an example of someone being appointed to be a leader. You know, if you're going for a position, you got to be what? Appointed to that position. I also thought about like being appointed, like going to a doctor's appointment, being appointed to head an organization. So that's what we're gonna look at today. We're gonna look at this is the two things, ladies and audience, I want you to look for as you go through the scriptures, two things. First of all, who is the scripture talking about? And what is it that's being appointed for them? What is their time of appointment? What is being appointed? You know, just real quickly, I think of our Bible study times. You know, we chose this time to study our Bibles, to do these lessons, didn't we? It's been what? Appointed. And we do it every week at the same day, at the same time, if something doesn't happen. So that's just an example of being appointed. Like we've been appointed to preach the gospel. We've been appointed to be prayer warriors. We've been appointed to be ministers and teachers and pastors. Whatever the title that God gives us, we've been what? Chosen or appointed to do it. And God has a calendar just like we do. So again, the key word today in the scriptures is going to be appointed. We're going to look at who's the scripture talking about and what is their time of appointment. So let's take a look at the first scripture. Matter of fact, Cherokee, we're going to have you to start us off. Let's take everyone over to Genesis chapter 18. And Sister Cherokee, I want you to read verses 13 and 14, okay? And then share with us what is you see in the scripture, who it is and what is their time appointed.
And the Lord said to Abraham, why did Sarah laugh, saying, shall I surely bear a child since I am old? Is anything too hard for the Lord? At the appointed time, I will return to you according to the time of life, and Sarah shall have a son.
All right. Very good. Thank you. So Sister Cherokee, who is the scripture talking about?
Talking about Sarah and Adam.
You mean Sarah and Abraham?
Yeah, sorry.
Okay, all right.
Sarah and Abraham.
Okay, and the key word is appointed. So what is Sarah's appointed time here? What's going on with Sarah? What's being appointed for her?
To have a child.
It's her appointed time
to have a child.
Uh-huh. And who told Sarah this? Who told her she was going to have this child?
The Lord.
Did y'all see that? The Lord put it on his calendar for Sarah, even in her old age. He appointed it. He chose her out of all the women. The Lord chose Sarah to bring forth that promised seed, which we already know later down was Isaac. Wow. Yeah. And to have a baby. So just think about when the Lord told Sarah that. Sandy, how long did it take for her to have that baby? What's the time frame to have a baby?
9 months.
So it was appointed within that time that he spoke to her, guaranteed 9 months, she was going to have that baby, didn't she? Because it was what? Appointed. So mm-hmm. when the Lord appoints you to do something, I guarantee you're going to do it. Some of us try to run away. He'll get you back like he did Jonah going to Nineveh. Mm-hmm. You're going to do what God told you to do. All right, then. Very good. Sandy, take us to the next scripture. Let's go to Job chapter 14.
Can you give me my...
And 14. Job 14, 14.
Okay.
Okay.
No, first.
If a man die, shall he live again? All the days of my appointed time will I wait till my change comes. So in essence, it's talking about his life.
Mm-hmm.
How long is he going to live? And at the appointed time, his life will be done. That's what I see. And that, and so he's just going to wait. But what we learned in another lessons, waiting doesn't mean just sitting there and doing nothing.
Right.
He's going to continue to do what he needs to do for the Lord. And then it says, till my change comes. So in essence, when your life is over, you die.
Mm-hmm.
And so that is an appointed time that only God knows. We don't know that, how long we got here.
Exactly. There you go. Exactly, Sister Sandy. And this is a really good scripture. I saw two things here. Did you notice what Job is saying? Job is asking a question. Notice he says, if. Now, remember now, Job is alive now. Job right. is full of aches and pains. His body is reeking with the boils and stuff. So Job is asking a question. Notice what he says. If a man, what? Die, shall he live again? He's asking a question. To me, I saw the resurrection here. Because see, when we die, we are going to rise again. We will live again to judgment day. We're going to rise for our judgment. Mm-hmm. And look what Job said also. He says, after the question, he says, what? All the days of my appointed time will I wait. So in other words, even in death, you still gonna have to wait. And so after death, your change is gonna come after death. But we can still see Job now talking about even in his present life, because remember, he's sitting there with boils all over him. So what is he saying? He ain't dead yet. So Job is saying what? I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna wait till my what? Change come. And he did wait, because if you keep reading, when you get to the end of the book of Job, chapter 42, what happened? Job change came, didn't it? He waited, didn't it? And he got everything back that he lost. Matter of fact, God gave him double. So whether you live or whether you die, your change is going to come. And it's been appointed. It's been appointed for us to die, and it's been appointed for us to rise again for the day of judgment. So talk about having a time appointed. Even God appointed it for Job. So it makes us no different. We have a life appointed to us as well. The key is, what are you doing with your appointment? What are you doing with the calling on your life? Very good, Sandy. Good one. Gina, you're going to take us now to Psalms. Audience, follow us with Gina over to Psalms 104. And Gina, I want you to read verse 1, then I want you to read 19. Verse 1, and then 19.
Blessed the Lord, O my soul, O Lord my God, thou art very great. Thou art clothed with honor and majesty. He appointed the moon for seasons, and the sun knoweth his going down. That's nice. So who is being God appointed? In the beginning, God created the sun, the moon, the stars for times and seasons. So is this kind of a reflection on, you know, Genesis is what I see.
Yep.
I see God appointed the sun, and I appointed the moon to show us seasons, to give us a time of marking the times, not just the year. And for the Jewish, it's for their seasons and their festivals and their it's for marking their time. So we got the sun, the moon, and it's showing us the appointed times.
Mm-hmm. So there it is right there. And who's playing a big part again in all of this? The Lord. The Lord, mm-hmm. again. I like how you brought in the fact about going back to Genesis. Did you notice how the writer showed us God's majesty, his honor, his glory? Mm-hmm. And with all of that, then he goes over and tells us, wait a minute, you know that moon and sun up there? He appointed it. Think about it like this. Mm-hmm. God has the moon appointed to tell us when the seasons are coming and changing. Can you imagine if the moon didn't do what it's supposed to do? Can you imagine if the sun said, I ain't gonna shine today? You ain't got no choice. You've been appointed. The moon don't have no choice. It's been appointed to do what it's supposed to do. Why? Because it was God that chose them. It was God that created them. And when God appoints you to do something, you will do it. Wow. Even down to the elements in the earth. Even everything. Think of it like this. Everything and everyone has a time. What? Appointed. Mm-hmm. Even the flowers have a certain time to live, die, and come back again. Everything has a what? Appointment. Even your ministry, even your calling, you've been appointed, you've been called, you've been chosen. So God did it for Job and them. God did it for Sarah and Abraham and them. He'll do it for the Carols, the Cherokees, the Sandys, and the Ginas, and the Marys, and the Bobs, and the Billies. Amen. All right, then. Cherokee, we're going to have you to take us to the next scripture. Take us over to Luke 22. Oh, this okay, and I want you to read. Oh, this is good, y'all. I want you to read verse 14, and then I want you to read 28, 29, and 30.
Okay, 14. When the hour had come, he sat down and the 12 apostles with him. Mm-hmm. Then he said to them
sweetie. Now I want you to go over to 28, 29, and 30.
But you are those who have continued with me in my trials, and I bestow upon you a kingdom, just as my Father bestowed my table in my kingdom, and sit on thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel.
Okay, let me just say, I think that's it right there. Did I say 30? Yeah, 30. Oh, no, that's it. So let me just say that word that in your Bible that said bestow, Sister Cherokee, mm-hmm. that's another word for appoint. So let's use that word as a point. It said bestow, but we know it means a point. Okay.
Did you want to read yours? Okay. You can go ahead and read your verse.
Okay. Let me read the King James Version, you guys, real quickly. And when the hour has come, he sat down and the 12 apostles with him. 28, 29, and 30 says, ye are they which have continued with me in my temptations, and I appoint unto you a kingdom, as my Father has appointed unto me, that you may eat and drink at my table in my kingdom, and sit on thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel. Wow. Oh, wow. So Jesus is talking to who, Sister Cherokee? He's talking to who?
Jesus is talking to, I believe, the 12 disciples.
You got it. Uh-huh, that's right. So just think of Jesus talking to his followers, the disciples, then, but he's talking to you and me today. We are his current disciples, okay? So what did Jesus tell them? Remember now, the key word is appointed. What did he tell them? What was their time of appointment? What did he appoint to them or bestow according to your text? What did he give them?
I believe food, right? Was it food?
Okay, let me give Gina a shot. What did he give them, Gina? What did he appoint?
He gave us the kingdom of heaven.
Stop right there. Did you hear that? Wait a minute. Mm-hmm. He appointed to them and to us a kingdom? What? Wow. Wow. Hey, you ladies, remember when we were little girls and we mothers, we know this. We taught our kids the Lord's Prayer in Matthew 6. And what did it say? Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy what? Kingdom come. That same kingdom that's coming is the same kingdom that God has already appointed to us. What? Let me just give you, you guys, real quickly, remember the story of Esther? Remember Esther? Remember when she went before the king and the king said, Esther, what is your petition? What is your request? He said, remember what he told her? He says, I will give you up to what? Half the kingdom. Okay. Remember John the Baptist? Remember when King Herod had Salome dancing before him? And what did he ask Salome? He said, Salome, what is it that you want? And what did he tell her? I will give you what? Up to half the kingdom. Did you notice those are earthly kings? Herod was an earthly king. The other king I just mentioned before, Esther's husband, he was an earthly king. But we got Jesus now. This is Jesus speaking, and he ain't giving us half of nothing. He said, I'm going to appoint to you the what? Kingdom. He didn't say half. So that means he got the whole kingdom. His Father gave it to him, appointed it to him. And now he's turning it around and he's appointing it to us. We got the whole kingdom, y'all. And we're going to sit on thrones. Wow. Talk about being chosen. Talk about being designated. I think you used one of those words in your description, Gina. So we all got a time appointed to us and we got the kingdom. I love those scriptures. Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. Sandy, take us over to 1 Thessalonians now. Let's go to 1 Thessalonians.
Okay.
Chapter 5. And Sandy, I want you to read for us verse 8, 9, and 10.
Okay. All right. But let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for the helmet, the hope of salvation. For God hath not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with him.
Mm.
Right. So this is talking about that we have... On earth here, we put the breastplate and we put the armor on for us during the process of being here on earth.
Mm-hmm.
And so it gives us the breastplate of faith and love and the helmet of hope and of salvation. But God has, he did not appoint us to wrath. He appointed us as for good. He appointed us, he gave us protection and he gave us the ability to go out and be like disciples and do what he wants us to do, whatever our path is. And that, and then by doing that, we accept the Lord as our savior, our salvation, Jesus Christ. And then because he died for us, and it says, whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with him. So whether we're awake doing what we do, or we're asleep, which would be, I guess, in the dead state,
right?
We wait for him.
Right.
We wait on him. And it's the whole process of why we were born and put here and what we need to do.
Mm-hmm. There it is. So here Paul is talking to the believers then, just like he's speaking to us today. And I love how Paul did this. Did you notice that Paul showed us that God has two appointments on his calendar? He appointed some people to his what? Wrath, but not us. We're not on that appointment calendar. We don't get that one. He says he has another appointment for us, and it is an appointment to what? Salvation. Wow. And I love that next scripture where Paul says, whether we live or whether we, how did Paul put it? Let me just get it. He said, whether we
wake or sleep.
Whether we wake or asleep. That made me think of that Job text that we had earlier. Remember what I said about Job? What Job said he could have been speaking, Job said, if I die, you know, that I'm going to wake up, you know, to my change is going to come. So here it is, that same parallel with Job. You could be alive, or it's speaking of when you're dead. Either way, you're going to wake up with Christ. And I love it because he said, we're going to live together with him. Talk about being appointed for salvation, not wrath. Because see, that's what Jesus' name means. Jesus means savior or salvation. So that was the appointment. He had an appointment on the cross and an appointment on the cross and in the tomb for him to rise up. That appointment applies for us today. Wow. Talk about an appointment on the calendar, salvation. Isn't this awesome? So we're gonna live together with him. That's a good appointment we wanna keep. All right, Gina, take us out to our last scripture. Let's go everyone to Acts 22. And Gina, I want you to read verse 10, and then I want you to read 14.
And I said, what shall I do, Lord? And the Lord said unto me, now this is the Lord speaking, arise and go into Damascus, and there it shall be told thee of all things which are appointed for thee to do. And drop down to 14. And he said, the God of our fathers has chosen thee that thou shouldest know his will, and see that just one, and shouldest hear the voice of his mouth. Mm. Now this is Paul. Mm-hmm. Paul who is the apostle to the Gentiles, the one who wrote like, you know, a lot of the New Testament. Mm-hmm. And Jesus is telling him, you know, arise, get your, you know, get going to Damascus. Because you have been appointed.
There you go.
This time, you know, you're, and then as you drop to 14, you're going to see what he's being appointed
right.
to. That you will know my will.
Yep.
And know that I am just one, the one God, Jesus, and that you should know and hear my mouth.
There it is. Isn't it? Did you see that? So here is Paul. Now, Paul is standing before the Jews and they're questioning him. And so he's reliving his experience on the Damascus road. So that's, he's just reiterating what went on. And I love it how Jesus now out of his own mouth told Paul what you've been appointed. In other words, Paul, you've been chosen. Paul had no idea that he was on God's calendar, did he? But when you meet God, when you have an encounter with the Lord, with the Spirit, with the Holy Spirit, when you get in your Bible and you begin to read it and hear the Spirit speak to you, you will know what your calling is. You will have your moment on the road of Damascus where God has said, Sandy, Gina, Cherokee, Carol, I have appointed you. I have chosen you. Matter of fact, to preach the gospel, share the good news, you know, and that's what we're doing today. Why? Because we've been what? Appointed. We are God is no respecter of persons. What he did for Paul and Peter and them, he'll do it for anyone else. But you got to get on the calendar with them. You got to say yes when he called you. All right then, ladies. Hey, listen, that's going to end that lesson right there. But real quickly, I want to ask each and every one of you, what did you learn in this lesson today? And I want to give you a couple minutes each. Sandy, let's start with you. What did you learn on this time appointed lesson number 21 today?
Okay. Basically, during your life, you give your life to Jesus, and then God will appoint you to do the path that you're supposed to do. And also through life and death, there is resurrection for you because you have given your life to Jesus. So that's another appointed time for you, your life. And then when you get resurrected, you go sit and have dinner with the Lord. You also have the ability to have a throne and a kingdom, not half a kingdom. So there's so many things that the Lord offers this in this appointed lesson today. And so it's really important that people know there are so much rewards that you can obtain in life and after death by giving your life to Jesus. Yeah, that's what I learned.
Amen. Amen. Sister Cherokee, what did you learn on this lesson today talking about the time, appointed time?
I learned that we really need to stop playing and we really need to get on that calendar. And he really wants to really use us. And I don't want to miss that date on the calendar. Very important that that we are ready. And that appointed, we have appointed time. We don't have this time that people think that you have time to figure out what you want to do. No, you have a time and it's appointed and it's pretty much like people that have gifts and have, you just said it, you know, that he wants to use us. We're on the calendar. So let's get ready.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Thank you, my sister. And Gina, close us out. What did you learn on this lesson talking about a time appointed?
One thing that really stood out to me was when the verse where he said that God does not appoint you to wrath, but unto salvation, because all mankind are appointed to salvation. It's a choice. So we're, you know, it's God is, like you said, God is no respecter of persons. He wants all to be saved. It's in his word. And it's just a matter of, you know, do we want that appointment? Like what Cherokee was saying, are we up for the appointment with God or are we not? So if you're not up for the appointment, you're in the wrath. And I don't want to be in the wrath. I want to be in the salvation, because the salvation is the door. You know, it's only the door. It's only the beginning. You know, to be saved is the gift of God. But as you walk through your salvation, then you walk to more appointment. It's like, you know, you get a job and you're on the ground floor, right? You get in the ground floor and then you get an appointment, right? And to get an appointment from God, hello.
Yeah.
Get an appointment, and then once that appointment, you meet that appointment. Guess what? Your phone's gonna ring, and God's gonna give you another appointment. And as you grow from salvation to, you know, to from being a baby to being a toddler to being a child, adult, and there's a lot of appointments waiting, and God's waiting for us just to say, "Yes, I want to meet with you."
Exactly. That's it. Wow. I don't need to add anything else, ladies. What another great lesson. Thank you all for your insight, your comments, and you was able to read the scriptures for yourself and see that even in the Bible, in the Old Testament and in the New Testament, even today, God is still making appointments because he doesn't want to give up on anyone. Everyone has the opportunity to be appointed to life, to take part of that tree of life. Like you were saying, Gina, in the scripture said, there are some people that's appointed on God's calendar for his wrath. And we know these are the children of disobedience. These are the children that are atheists that refuse to believe what Jesus did on that cross. Well, don't blame God when your appointment day come and he tell you, you're a goat, now go to the left. Don't get mad at God because he gave you plenty of time to see he had calendars and who was on what. So thank you all. God bless you all. We do look forward. Audience, we pray that you enjoyed these lessons with us. And we look forward to you being with us next week on lesson number 22, right here at blackhoopministries.com. You don't want to miss our other websites. We have lessons at mybibleregistration.com. And we also have Bible lessons at SourceOutreachMinistries.com as well. All right then. Hey, God has appointed us a lot of work to do. So we're doing the work of the Lord. God bless you all. I'm Minister Love. We love you and we look forward to seeing you this time next week. Take care. All right. Okay, ladies.